Okay, so now we're going to put the rocker base on. I'm going to start with a new gasket. Same thing on these. They have a stamp in them where one side is raised and this side's recessed. I always put the raised side up, and it just happens to be that that would make the part number go the right way. That goes on there. Same thing on the other one. Surfaces are clean. The front one, we can go ahead and put the push rods in because we got room. These are marked. The three rings is the exhaust, the one is the intake, and you can tell because when you line them up, the exhaust push rod is always a little bit longer. So the front, we can put those in. The rear, we take the, I'll just give this one more wipe. I did clean this with brake clean. I cleaned the bolts with brake clean because we're going to be putting Loctite in that. I'll do that right now. Put a little dab of blue on here. And I took the spark plug side support bolts out for the extra clearance to get over the valve spring. So we're going to slip this in. And I got all those other bolts hanging down in the way. Get our gasket lined up a little bit. I'm gonna leave these, I flipped these rockers up like that. And you can put your push rods in. The other thing I do is I hold the push rods up to the light and sight through the oil hole, or just blow them out with a blow gun. These ones I did blow out and I wiped them down. So put those in. Put a little dab of oil on the tip of the valves. And the lifters, or the, and the push rods. Just for the initial startup. So now we can lift this up and flip our rockers up in the right place. Get our bolts going through our gasket the right way. And I think I have to roll the engine over a little bit. Let me check. Okay, we're good there. Now we can Loctite our other bolts. Put those in. Make sure those are started through the gasket. I'm also going to, oops. I'm also going to put the Allen head corner bolts in just to help line up the gasket. For these, I use this is a Craftsman ratchet wrench, and then this is a neat tool that I got years ago. It's a little socket adapter. You could put it inside of another socket if you wanted just a little bit more height. All right, put it in these ratchet wrenches, and then you get a low profile ratchet, which is nice for these rocker boxes. Make sure these other ones are started. I don't torque these anymore, I just get them tight. I think the torque might be 15 foot-pounds. These ones aren't too bad. The older Evolution Softails. There is, I don't know, it's even 3/8 of an inch between the top of the rocker and the bottom of the frame for the cover, the rocker cover. So you have to use a really short Allen to get in there. And those are a pain. Get in there. This short now. I'm gonna run this one down with a short one. This one back here is a little tight, but not terrible. Okay, so I like to let that sit for just a couple minutes and let the lifters bleed down to let the valves close. On a big twin, when you have the pushrod tubes collapsed, you can reach in there and spin the pushrod, or yeah, any big twin. When you have the pushrod tubes collapsed, you can reach in there and spin the pushrods, and then you know that the lifters have bled down and the valves are closed. So just gave that a couple minutes. Now I'm gonna roll it over until the front is on close to the top dead center compression. Right there. Another little drop of oil on there. That's nice and clean. Put our little bit of Loctite on here. Get our corner bolts ready. The nice thing about these wrenches is the clicks are real fine and real smooth, so there's not a lot of drag on it when you go to back your wrench up. It's nice for tight spaces. Working on bikes, it's nice to have a good ratchet, and especially a soft-handled ratchet. This is Snap-on. I like Snap-on ratchets. This one isn't real fine-tooth, but it's a nice little ratchet. And the soft handle is nice because, you know, any kind of painted surface, you could chip it real easy with a hard-handled ratchet, or if you drop it or something, you know, this handle isn't going to do a lot of damage, so it's always nice to have a nice ratchet. Same thing on 3/8. Now, this one's beat up and old, but it's still pretty decent shape. But this one has such fine teeth on it that this is one of my favorites. Okay, so we're gonna put the intake back on. I got the intake all cleaned up. The flanges have a front and a rear. They're specific. And the taper goes out to grab the seal. This is the front. It goes on like that. Rear. And I'm going to take the new, got some new seal, so I'm just going to put a little bit of this plastic on there. I got a couple 5/16 hex heads I'm going to put on the left hand side so we can get a wrench on them. Put a little blue Loctite on there. Threads are buggered up on there. Put our new seals on there. Get our bolts ready for this side. A little Loctite. Now we're going to put our lower rocker gasket on. This is a new style gasket that they came out with. Kind of locks down into the grooves here. Flat on the bottom. It's got a ridge on the top. Just want to make sure it's down in the groove, and especially when you put the middle section in, you want to make sure that this is all down in the groove and it's sitting good, because it'd be easy for that thing to get out of place. Now we can put our middle section in. This is all I wiped all these surfaces down with thinner. And you want to make sure that your umbrella valve is up here in the front. These engines breathe the crankcase up through the pushrod tubes and into the rockers. And then that breathes through underneath this umbrella valve, and it has some oily air that comes out in here. And then that goes down through here and out through the breather bolt and into the air cleaner. Put the middle gasket in there. Why they made those white, I have no idea. I'm going to go on the other side and check that lower brown gasket and make sure it's in the right place. Yeah, that looks good. Now we can put our upper gasket in place. Same thing here, it's got to be in the grooves real nice. Yeah, you see how it didn't want to go in there. I think I could stretch it a little bit. Okay. Same thing, make sure everything stays in place. Go over on the other side and look. Somebody painted these rockers with just spray paint. That's why they look like that. Looks good. I put a new paper gasket on these bolts. Now I just want to make sure that these surfaces are lined up. Just feel the other side too. And we'll just snug it down a little bit. Look at the other side.
Looks good.
And the center. Thank you. For these, you gotta have a really nice swivel socket. This is a Matco. I think it's an impact style socket, but it's got a nicer ball type swivel on it than a regular swivel socket. So I always like this one. It's a half inch. And this muffler on the back was missing a bolt, so I gotta find a bolt for that and tighten up the muffler. I found a nice grade 8 bolt in a washer. I gotta slip this back a little bit. And this, it's kind of like a Stover nut. It's a lock nut, flange nut. So that shouldn't fall off of there. Nice and tight. Okay, now we're going to struggle with the magnet. Tighten up the muffler clamp if we can. Crank that right down. Hopefully it. Check the front. That one wasn't very tight either. Now I'll go ahead and tighten these up all the way. I put new gaskets in there, so they're gonna crush in there a little bit, so just keep going back and forth. Try to seat that in. Tighten up this nut, that's fun to get at. This pin for the brake lever isn't original. Looks like it's gonna work okay. And I put Loctite on it.
actions. Remember how I got that out of there.
Get the oil draining on this. These Sportsters just have a drain hose that comes down from the tank, and it just dead ends on the frame right here. There's a little there's like a little nipple thing that it pushes onto. This one just has a spring clamp. Slide that back. Pull the hose off. And that's gonna about do it for today. So I'm just going to let this oil drain while I'm away for a day or so. I'll go pull the dipstick out so it can drain out, and just let that drain for a day, and I'll get the filter draining on it. Actually, I could do that right now. Yeah, she was due for an oil change. But luckily it had oil in it with all the leaks that it had. So we'll pick it up next time. Hey, we're going to replace the choke cable on this. These choke cables always break right here, where behind the nut on the bracket. So just loosen this up. Kind of hard to get in there. Especially on the bike, it's impossible to try to get this nut out of there. Then you push, or you pull the spring down, pop this off. Pull the spring out. Knock everything over. Pull the cable out of this elbow. Now you take your new cable, put it through the elbow, put your spring on, pull your spring down, slip this over the ball, and then let your spring go. And that's the it's not actually a choke, it's called an enrichener, because on the CV carburetors, when this opens, it opens another air passage that sucks fuel right from the float bowl. So it's not a, it doesn't choke off the Venturi like a conventional choke. It's a, it's actually an enrichener. You can run the bike more, you can run down the road with the enrichener on with like a typical choke. You wouldn't be able to because the engine wouldn't be getting any air. Slip that in and then carefully start the plastic threads. And just snug this. Pushes into that boot. Put some Loctite on our breather bolts. Back down. thing just got really carefully just snug. Because you can, because it's just plastic. That probably hasn't worked that good in a long time. I think once I get the tank on, I'll zip tie that stuff up. Off in the speedo drive. I'm gonna put some of this cable life down inside the new cable. That up in the drive. not any too long. Once it gets hot, this top side will kind of sag down a little bit and fall into place. I'll snug up the nut on the back of the speedometer. So that takes care of that. All we gotta do is put the filter on. I dumped the oil. Well, I think you guys saw that. All I gotta do is put the filter on it and put oil in it, put the tank on it, now he wanted me to look at the wiring in the back too. Let's take a look at that. Put some oil in the filter, lubed up the seal, wiped off the sealing surface, and threw that on, just hand tight. Probably hard to see in there, but let me get my light. Put that back on the barb there. And a little wipe down. Everything had oil on it. Things puking everywhere. Clean off these head bolt covers. Well, off camera, I got the tank on, the seat on, and it fired right up. It's running good. This guy's gonna be happy. This top end is all sealed up and nice and dry. I cleaned everything up for him while my dad cleaned the heads and cylinders, but everything else is cleaned up. Cleaned the carburetor real good. All that stuff was all really grungy. He can take it the next step and give it a good degreasing. It's still pretty nasty underneath. Did a clutch adjustment, adjusted up his primary chain, put that speedometer cable on there. I have to remind him that he needs a battery hold down. There's no battery hold down right now. And I think he's gonna come back sometime and I'll do something with the rear turn signals. And yeah, other than that, he should be ready to ride. It's a nice riding bike. He's gonna take it somewhere and have a rear tire put on it because I don't have a tire machine. And that's the wrong tire. That's a dresser front tire. So yeah, thanks for tuning in. Thanks for watching the video, and I hope you guys enjoyed that, especially somebody that's gonna try to tackle a job like that. I hope I went through the steps good enough where somebody that didn't know what they were doing could watch the video and figure things out. And so that was a nice little project. I haven't really shown any Harley motor work on here yet, so I think that came out good, and he's gonna be happy. There's a lot of little things that were loose on here that are tightened up and fixed, and so I think he's really gonna be happy. He said he's gonna buy mirrors for it. This thing is loose and rattling around. But other than that, I think that's about it for this one. And if you guys enjoyed the video, please hit the like button, click subscribe, share the video if you can. And leave a comment down below. Let me know what you're working on. If you got a Harley or metric bike or four-wheeler, I got another four-wheeler in there I'm working on. I did start working on that green truck in there. I got that on the lift. That needs a starter, and the positive and ground cables are shot, so I got to replace that. But getting going on that a little bit. So, I think that's about it for this one, guys, and I appreciate everybody watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks.